Hello everyone, welcome back. I thought I said it like that. Welcome to another theatre vlog. I'm in Liverpool today, as I always am, and I'm going to see the Cher show at the Liverpool Empire. So I thought that I'd vlog it. I want to do more theatre vlogs this year, as I keep saying. So yeah, I'm going to bring you guys with me. I'll show you everything I get up to at the theatre, and I'll film the curtain call and everything. Yeah, so that's all I'm going to say for now. I'll speak to you guys in a bit. the theatre. It was really good. It was better than I thought it would be. I thought it would just be like another jukebox musical, but it wasn't. It was more than that, and I'll explain more about it in the review. Yeah, I'll speak to you guys when I get home. Hello! Welcome to the review section of the video. We're going to be talking about The Cher Show, as I mentioned already in this video. Yeah. So, The Cher Show is basically what you'd expect. It's the story of Cher's life. It's a biopic musical, and it's a jukebox musical. All of the songs in this musical were Cher's songs. It was a jukebox musical, obviously, but it just, something felt different about it. It was really good. It was just a really, really good show, and it was really good to learn more about Cher. I didn't know much about her. I knew the base, you know, the not basic, main stuff that everybody knows. But there were lots of things I didn't know. It was really interesting. I do really like biopic musicals. Yeah. Okay, anyway, so let's talk about the cast for the show. I don't even need to open the programme to talk about the three shows. We have Millie O'Connell, Neil Steers, and Debbie Corrup. I say three shows because they have different people playing Cher at different points in her life. So we have Millie O'Connell, who's playing Babe, which is the Cher that is, which is Cher from about, I can't remember what age it was, but it went from Cher when she's little to, I think, about mid-20s. Then they have Danielle Steers, who plays Lady, who is like middle-aged Cher. Well, no, I don't want to say that, because then that could be saying that the last Cher is really old, but I don't know how to, I'd say like mid-20s, playing Cher from mid-20s up until maybe like 40-ish, I'm going to say. And then the rest of the years were played by Debbie Corrup, who played Star, because that's the show that we see now, the Star. So yeah, it's the story of how she got to where she is now. And it was really, really good. A really, really good show. I enjoyed the rest of the cast as well, but the only people I recognised were Danielle Steers, Millie O'Connell, and then Debbie Corrup. Like Lucas Rush, who played Sonny, was really good. Haven't seen him in anything before, I don't think. We had Jake Mitchell, who was playing Bob, and Tori Scott, who played Georgia. Yeah. Now, this is a revival. So this was on Broadway ages ago. It had Stephanie J. Block in it, and it was like a massive deal when it was on Broadway, and then it closed. There was some drama behind it closing. There was not a production of it until now, when this UK one came out. Was it? I think it might have been early on last year. This was the first time this show has been in the UK. So not only was it revival, it was also a UK premiere of the show. I reckon it might end up on the West End, because the tour's done really well. I'd like to see it on the West End. If it was in the West End and I went to London, I might see it again, because it was really good. I don't think I'll be able to catch the tour again, because it's nearly the end of its tour. If I'm really excited about a tour and it's going to Liverpool like right at the end of it, and I have to wait ages, I'll try and see it somewhere else. But with this tour, I just waited until it got to Liverpool. I didn't bother going to Manchester or Leeds or anywhere like that, because it just wasn't a show that I was like dying to see. But I knew that if I didn't see it, I would have probably kicked myself a bit and would have been annoyed, because everybody has been raving about it. But there we go, I've seen it now and I really, really enjoyed it. The ensemble in this show as well played a massive part. They were on stage for most of the show. There were a couple of moments where they weren't, but they were on stage most of the show, and they had a big involvement in the show, which was really nice to see. They didn't just come in for the dance number, dance around and leave. They were on the stage a lot, and it was really nice to see that. It was also great that all three Chers were on the stage at the same time. So even like if they were telling the story of Babe, then they had the two other Chers at the back. Well, not at the back, just somewhere on the stage, and they'd make comments, sometimes interact with the Cher that's
front and centre.
There were a couple of characters who obviously weren't on stage all the time, but most of the cast were always there and had some massive involvement, which was really good. Oti Mabuse, what is he? I don't know. It's Oti Mabuse or Oti Mabuse or Oti Mabuse. It's one of the three. I don't want to like butcher the name, so it's one of those three. I think it's Oti Mabuse though. Oti Mabuse. Anyway, she did the choreography for this show. She's from Strictly, so I expected good choreography, and we got that. And Arlene Phillips was the director as well. I feel like most theatre fans know who Arlene Phillips is. She is a massive deal in musical theatre. She was on I'm a Celeb recently, so yeah. That's all I am going to say in this review section. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, like it, subscribe, turn notification bell on. Follow me and Sam on Instagram at Carter.Gilling and Sam.Ross_16. I'll see you all in the next video. I haven't got any more shows out until next month, so I'll vlog them. I think I'm seeing those shows with Sam, so I'm sure we'll do a joint vlog for them. And yes, that is all I'm gonna say. Hope you have enjoyed this video. I've got to get out a film review as well next week.
Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you all in the next one.